Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. In this video, we are going to cover the current affairs for mobile optimized ebook. Please install GKToday Academy app. And you can get the current affairs of entire 1 year. For regular updates, please join our Telegram channel. All the infographics and revision oriented content is posted there. The link is given in the description as well as in the pinned comment. So now, let's start the quiz. The National Maritime Heritage Complex is to be set up in which state of India? So it is going to be set up in Gujarat in Lothar. It should be noted that it was in news recently because the president of Portugal is in India and both countries, that means India and Portugal, are collaborating for this National Maritime Heritage Complex in Gujarat in Lothar. Now if we talk about Gujarat, recently Gujarat was news as KVIC launched first silk processing plant in our country in Gujarat in Surendranagar district, and this is for the processing of silk for patola saris. KVIC is a statutory body under MSME ministry, and the present minister is Mr. Nitin Gadkari. His constituency is Nagpur. KVIC was also in news as recently it collaborated with Titan to make khadi wristwatches, which is first and the only private firm to build and deliver research ships in our country. So recently, Indian private firm Titagarh Wagons Limited commissioned the second coastal research vessel Sagar Anveshika, and the first research ship was Sagar Tara. So by commissioning these two vessels, it has become the first and only private firm to build and deliver research ships in our country. What is the theme of 56th Munich Security Conference 2020? So the theme was Westlessness, and this conference held in Munich in Germany. And from Indian side, our External Affairs Minister Mr. S. Jaishankar represented India. Mr. Jaishankar is the member of Rajya Sabha from Gujarat. So our External Affairs Minister is Mr. Jaishankar, and our Foreign Secretary is Mr. Harshvardhan Sringla. Recently, he was appointed as Foreign Secretary. Previously, he was India's Ambassador to USA. Now, India's Ambassador to USA is Mr. Taranjit Singh Sandhu. Previously, he was India's High Commissioner to Sri Lanka. Now, Mr. Gopal Bagale has been appointed as the India's High Commissioner to Sri Lanka. Recently, Sri Lanka was in news as the Prime Minister of Sri Lanka was on visit to India. Answer in comment box, what is the name of Prime Minister of Sri Lanka? What is the name of third corporate passenger train of India? So it is Kashi Mahakal Express. It should be noted that IRCTC is set to launch the third corporate passenger train, and this Kashi Mahakal Express will connect Varanasi and Indore. So three corporate passenger trains are, first is Tejas Express, and it connect Lucknow and Delhi. That means its route is Lucknow and Delhi. Second is between Ahmedabad and Mumbai, and this is third one that is going to connect the Indore and Varanasi, and the name is Kashi Mahakal Express. It should be noted that this will connect three temples. One temple is Omkareshwar Temple, this temple is near Indore, and second temple is Mahakaleshwar Temple, this is in Ujjain, and third is Kashi Vishwanath Temple. So this third corporate train connect these three temples, and it is important point, it could be asked in exam. Now if we talk about IRCTC, it is subsidiary of Indian Railways, and IRCTC stands for Indian Railway Catering and Tourism Corporation. So it is a subsidiary of Indian Railway, and recently Indian Railways was in news as RPF, that is Railway Protection Force, was renamed as Indian Railways Protection Force Service. And recently Mr. V.K. Yadav was reappointed as the chairman of Railway Board for one more year. Kambala, which was seen in news recently, is a traditional sport of which state? So it is a traditional sport of Karnataka, and in which people of coastal district of Karnataka conduct a buffalo race. Now it was in news recently as one of the local contestant named Mr. Srinivas Gowda covered the 142.5 meter Kambala in 13.62 seconds. Now, answer in comment box, Jallikattu is associated to which state of India? Now coming back to Karnataka, Karnataka was also in news as recently state government launched Jan Sevak program to provide government services by home delivery. Karnataka was also in news as it was the top state as per India Innovation Index. Answer in comment box which organization released this index. Apart from that, Karnataka was also in news as it decided to install GPS devices on the garbage trucks. That means trucks which are used for the disposal of garbage. So the GPS devices are to be installed on these trucks to prevent the corruption in garbage disposal. Yes, Bharti Award is the highest award of which state or union territory? So it is the highest award of Uttar Pradesh, and recently it was in news as the state government announced that this Yes Bharti Award is to be replaced with State Cultural Award. Which state commenced operations of India's first intercity electric bus service? So this first intercity electric bus service is going to operate between Mumbai and Pune, and recently it was inaugurated by the Union Transport Minister Mr. Nitin Gadkari. So this first intercity electric bus service was started in Maharashtra. Now for the promotion of electric vehicles, there is a scheme named FAME. Answer in comment box, it is a scheme of which union ministry? Now coming back to Maharashtra, recently state was in news as it decided to set up Swachh Bharat World University in Wardha to mark the birth anniversary of Gandhiji. State was also in news because of Cyber Safe Women initiative. So the idea of this initiative is to create awareness about cyber safety. As per the recent military balance report, the defense modernization of which country led to higher military spending by the USA? So recently, London-based IISS, that is International Institute for Strategic Studies, released a annual report, and the title was Military Balance. And as per this report, it was stated that global spending on defense increased by 4% in 2019. So this is global spending, and this is the largest growth in last 10 years. And this increase is mainly because of USA and China. So this report revealed that the defense modernization of China led to higher defense spending by USA. Both USA and China increased their defense spending by more than 6%. To be precise, it is 6.6%. So the right answer is China, and because of higher spending by China, USA also started spending more on the defense modernization. Now recently, China was also in news as SIPRI, that is Stockholm International Peace Research Institute, released a report, and as per that report, China is now world's second largest arms producer. China is behind USA, and recently it left Russia behind. So now USA is on first position, China on second, and Russia is behind China. Which country has recently developed a recovery plasma to treat COVID-19 infected patients? So this country is China, and it developed recovery plasma to treat the patients. Actually, the biotechnology research company of China collected the plasma from recovered patients to treat the infected patients. Now, COVID-19 stands for Coronavirus Disease 2019, and this disease outbreak started in 2019 in Wuhan in China. Now answer in comment box, Wuhan is in which province of China? And recently WHO declared this outbreak as public health emergency. WHO was also in news because of aware campaign, and the objective of this campaign is to spread awareness about antibiotic resistance. WHO was also in news because of 3S strategy. Answer in comment box, what is this 3S strategy? Which late basketball player was recently named finalist of Basketball Hall of Fame? So he is Mr. Kobe Bryant, who died recently in a helicopter crash, and he was named as the finalist of Basketball Hall of Fame. Mr. Bryant played for Los Angeles Lakers. What is the theme of this year's multilateral naval exercise of India, Milan. So the theme is Synergy Across the Seas, and it is biggest multilateral naval exercise in the Indian Ocean region, and it is set to be organized at Visakhapatnam in Andhra Pradesh. And this exercise has been hosted by India since 1995. Now for Indian Ocean region, there is an organization named Indian Ocean Rim Association. The most recent Council of Ministers of IORA held in UAE. Answer in comment box, which country recently became the 22nd member of IORA? Who is the head of Municipal Bonds Development Committee that was constituted by SEBI? So, Mr. Sujit Prashad is the head of this committee, which was constituted by the Securities Exchange Board of India. So, this committee will advise SEBI on the development of municipal debt securities and issuance of municipal bonds. Now, what is the meaning of this municipal bonds? Actually, these are the loan that are provided by the investors to these municipal bodies when they issue bonds. So these municipal bodies will issue bonds and the people will invest in these bonds, and this money is utilized for the various projects of municipal authorities. These are also known as muni bonds. According to a study by RBI, which state attracted the highest project investment in 2018-19? So Andhra Pradesh attracted the highest project investments. Last year, Maharashtra was on top position. But this year, Maharashtra was on top position in terms of investment over a 5-year period. And in 2018-19, Andhra Pradesh is on top. Andhra Pradesh is followed by Tamil Nadu, and Maharashtra is on third position. And if we talk about the investment in last 5 years, then Maharashtra is still on the top position. Now, the study was conducted by RBI. Recently, RBI was in news as Mr. Janak Raj has been appointed as the Executive Director of Monetary Policy Department by RBI. It should be noted that the RBI Governor is the head of Monetary Policy Committee. And in this committee, there are 6 members, out of which 3 are from RBI and 3 are appointed by the Government of India. And RBI Governor is the head of this Monetary Policy Committee. Present Governor is Mr. Shaktikant Das, and recently he was selected as the Banker of Year for Asia Pacific region. The General Insurance Corporation of India is set to commence reinsurance business in which country? So this country is Russia, and recently Russia has given license to GICRE to commence reinsurance business in Russia. GIC stands for General Insurance Corporation. Russia was also in news as recently Mr. Mikhail Mishustin was appointed as the new Prime Minister of Russia. Russia was also in news as recently WADA, that is World Anti-Doping Agency, banned Russia for 4 years on doping charges. Which Indian state has recently radio tagged an Indian pangolin on the occasion of World Pangolin Day? So this state is Madhya Pradesh, and as you can see in picture, this is Indian pangolin. And on the occasion of World Pangolin Day, that means 15th February, the Forest Department of Madhya Pradesh radio tagged the Indian pangolin. And this radio tagging was done by WCT, that is Wildlife Conservation Trust. Now, what is the purpose of this radio tagging? With this tagging, the movement of this Indian pangolin can be traced to understand its ecology and to understand its behavior. Now, if we talk about World Pangolin Day, it is celebrated on the third Saturday of February month. The Pandit Deendayal Upadhyay Memorial Center is built in which Indian city? So, it is in Varanasi, and it is to be inaugurated by Indian Prime Minister Mr. Modi. The Prime Minister is also going to unveil the statue of Pandit Deendayal Upadhyay in Varanasi. Apart from that, the Prime Minister will also inaugurate the third corporate train, and the route of this train is from Varanasi to Indore. The Chief Minister of Uttar Pradesh is Mr. Yogi Adityanath, and the Governor is Ms. Anandiben Patel. Which city is to host the Organic Food Festival to promote women entrepreneurs? So, Ministry of Food Processing and Ministry of Women and Child Development collaborated to organize this Organic food festival in Delhi. And the idea behind this food festival is to assist women entrepreneurs in the organic food sector. Now, Ms. Harsimrat Kaur Badal is the Minister of Food Processing Industries, and Ms. Smriti Irani is the Minister of Women and Child Development. She recently launched a scheme, Yashaswini. Answer in comment box in which state of India this scheme was launched. Ms. Sonam Sherpa, who died recently, was the famous personality in which field? So, he was associated to music and he was the founder of famous music band Parikarma, and Sonam Sherpa was the lead guitarist of this band. System risk indicator, which was seen in news recently, is associated to which country? So it is associated to Netherlands, and it is a identification mechanism, and recently it was ruled out by the court citing the reasons of data privacy. So the system was started in 2014 to identify the persons who would probably commit fraud and receive government benefits. So recently the court of Netherlands passed a verdict in this context, and that is why this system risk indicator was in news. So the system was to identify those who can commit fraud. Now recently Netherlands was also in news as it decided to drop the nickname Holland. So these were the important questions of today's quiz. Thank you, and that's all for the day.